Parashat Pinchas. One of the very fascinating passages is in this portion because it deals with the succession of leadership. The leadership of Moses is ending. The leadership of Yehoshua is beginning. And once again, the Torah mentions that Moses sinned in striking the rock, and therefore new leadership is necessary. And Moses says to God, "May the Lord, the God of different spirits for every human being, appoint an individual over the witness congregation of Israel. An individual who will go out before them and who will come in before them, who will bring them out and who will bring them in, so that the witness congregation of the Lord will not be like sheep without a pastor, without a shepherd." What was Moses' leadership and what was Joshua's leadership? Moses led the Jews in the very dawn of their history, when the Jews were literally in diapers, when they were just beginning to feel free. And Moses led them as a parent must lead a small child. Commands the child, doesn't explain, says it clearly, specifically. Don't cross the street yourself, it's dangerous. Don't touch the fire. Don't go into the water without an adult. All of this is what Moses gives to the children of Israel. Moses is a man of God and gives God's definitive words to the entire congregation as one. Not only to the entire congregation of his generation, but the Torah of God given by Moses is the Torah for all generations. And that was fine for the generation that was still birthing a warning in the infancy stage, young child stage. Now the Jews have had 40 years in the desert. They've come of age. A different leadership is expected. Those of you who have teenage children understand very well, they don't accept what you say because you say it. You have to explain it. They have to feel part of what you're asking them to do. You have to bring them in, make them feel that you're partners. Whole different kettle of fish, whole different kind of leader. When you're used to leading children and have to lead young adults, sometimes you can't do it very well. You get impatient and angry. Moses got impatient and angry. He was disappointed. They didn't always follow him exactly. They didn't do what he asked them to do. He was asking in the name of God. But he never tried to convince them that God's will was good for them. And the rock symbolizes the Jewish people who are hard as a rock, stubborn, kshei oref, hard, stiff-necked. and he's upset at them. And he strikes the rock, displaced anger. He was really striking the nation, wanted to strike the nation. And he calls out at them, "Listen now, you rebels." And such a leader cannot continue. It needs a different leadership style. It needs a whole change in tactic. Moses himself understands this. May the Lord God, the God of all different spirits of every individual human being, the God who understands that each individual is a world unto himself, that it's not one Torah for all, the explanation of the laws must differ in terms of the personalities and needs of the individual. And the new leader cannot simply take God's word and impose it on the nation. He must work with them, include them, partner with them. He must go out before them and come in before them. He must even take them by the hand and show them the way. He must bring them out and bring them in. He must bring them along to understand God's will, not simply command God's will. That's a necessary change in the life of parent-child, in the life of leader-congregation. And as gracefully as possible, Moses himself commands this change in the verses in our week's portion. Shabbat Shalom.